Shuklam Varadharam Vishnum Sashivarnam Chaturbhujam Prasannavadanam Dhyayet Sarva Vigno Pashantaye Sadashiva Samarambham Shankaracharya Madhyamam Asmadacharya Padyantam Vande Guru Paramparam Saraswati Namastubhyam Varade Kamarupini Vidyaramham Karishyami Siddhir Bhavatume Sada. Om Parthaya Pratibodhitam Bhagavata Narayanena Swayam Vyasena Gradhitam Purana Munina Madhye Mahabharatam Advaitamritavarishinim Bhagavatim Ashtadashadhyayinim Ambatva Manusandadhami Bhagavad-gita bhavad-dveshini. Hari Om, Suprabhatam, all of you. Yesterday we finished, we covered 6 slokas. Today we'll start from the 7th verse, 7th sloka. So, Sri Bhagavan Vacha, Sri Bhagavan's words. So as we studied yesterday, first we will do the pada-pada-pada. Each word we will split and see, and then we will come to the sloka. Sloka number 7. Ahāraha tu api sarvasya trividhaha bhavati Priyah, yajñah, tapah, tatha, danam, tesham, bhedam, imam, shrunu. So many words are there in this verse. Now we'll see what line by line. I will chant. Please repeat. Aharastvapi sarvasya
Aharastvapi sarvasya
Aharastvapi sarvasya
Aharastvapi sarvasya
Trividho bhavati priyah
Trividho bhavati priyah
Trividho bhavati priyah
Trividho bhavati
Yajñastapastathādānam Tesham bhedamimam shrunu
Tesham
bhedamimam shrunu So, once more we'll see. Aharastvapi sarvasya trividho bhavati priyah.
Aharastvapi sarvasya trividho bhavati priyah.
Yajñastapastadadanam tesham bhedamimam shrunu.
Yajñastapastadadanam.
Okay. Here there are two places we have to put little Shraddha. That is, one is Aharastvapi Sarvas. There, sometimes when children chant, there are possibility of some small errors because E and Sir, they mix up little bit. That's a place we can, we should be a little careful when we are teaching. Then the Shrunu, that Sr, you know, Sr becomes little difficult for the children, so that also those are two places we should pay little attention when we are teaching. No, kind of shrinu, that ragara in different places chanted a little differently. Sometimes ragara is chanted as ri, so Krishna, Krishna, no? R is something they add u to it, so it becomes Krishna. Sometimes it becomes e, it becomes Krishna. But actually, the that is a independent swara, a, e, u, r. That is the correct pronunciation. R. So shrunu. That's the correct one. Okay. We'll chant once more.
Aharastvapi sarvasya trividho bhavati priyah.
Aharastvapi sarvasya trividho bhavati priyah.
Yajnas tapas tadadanam tesham bhedamimam srinu.
Yajnas tapas tadadanam tesham bhedamimam srinu.
As we did yesterday, we'll cover four verses and then we'll come back. If you have any doubts, we will clarify that. Okay. Now to the eighth verse. This is a very important verse in this chapter regarding the chanting. Because the first two lines actually is one word. Two lines, one word. So in many places, they split in between, which is actually not acceptable. Okay. So this is a big word. We are going to, actually it's very simple only, but sometimes we split wrongly. Okay. I will chant. Ayusattvaba, this is the word, first word.
Ayusattvabala rogya sugha priti vivardhana.
This is a compound word. Compound word, samastapada. Where so many words are put together to become one word. So how many words are actually? Ayuhu, sattva, bala, arogya, sukha, priti, vivardhana. So many words are put together and it became one word. So you should be a little careful in this chanting this. Generally, sometimes, no, in many places they chant like ayu, sattva, bala, arogya, sukha, priti, vivardhana. That is actually wrong. Because a compound word cannot be broken in between. That's a very important law in chanting. Okay. So this is, so when we, even if we are chanting other verses like, one verse like, aha, generally in Chinmaya Mission, obviously we chant like, one line. So, aha, rastvapi sarvasya, trividho bhavati, like that we chant. But in this two, three verses, where samastapada is there, we should teach our children that there we should not break in between. That's a very important point we should teach our children. Okay.
Ayusattva bala rogya sukha priti vivardhana is one word.
Next word is dasyaha. Next is snigdhaha.
Snigdhaha.
Sthiraha.
Sthiraha.
Hridyaha. Aharaha.
Aharaha.
Sattvika priyaha.
Sattvika priyaha.
Yeah. So many words are there in this one shloka. So now we'll chant. Please repeat.
Ayusattva. Here be careful. Ayusattva, not ayu. Ayuhu sattva.
That visarga will change into sa. That we have studied yesterday, no? Visarjaniyasya saha. That ayuhu sattva, that visarga, the dot between after you and before sa, will change into sa. I will show here. So please see the ayusattva, ayuhu sattva, that visarga will change into sa. This is something we should be careful about, okay? Ayusattva, when we chant, that visarga changes to sa. Ayusattva. Okay, so ayusattva. Tvabalarogya sukha priti vibardhana. Sukha priti vibardhana. So, ayuhu. So, first we should know the words. Ayuhu sattva. Together become ayusattva. Next is bala, strength. Arogya. So, we there also that yesterday we studied, no? Vibhurta and Samvrita. So, balarogya. Balarogya nahi. Balarogya sukha priti vibardhana. Ayusattva balarogya sukha priti vibardhana. Very good. Okay. So, that's what should be. This is a verse we can actually ask for the elder children to chant. This is something which will be. Ayusattva balarogya sukha priti vivardhana. Next verse. Yasya snigdha sthira hridya. See, that same rule applies here also. So that Visarga will change into S everywhere. Yasya snigdha. See, yasya plus snigdha become. Rasya snigdha sthira hridya.
Rasya snigdha
sthira hridya. Ahara sattvika priya.
Ahara sattvika priya.
Ahara sattvika. That Visarga will change into sir. So actually in your chanting book, you know, which you are using for chanting, all these places you make that Visarga into sir, it's easy. So that when we teach, we'll remember that. So wherever this change comes, then we make a note like sir. Wherever the Visarga will change it. So that it becomes we remember it. Rasya snigdha sthira hridya.
Rasya snigdha sthira hridya.
Ahara sattvika priya.
Ahara sattvika priya.
Sattvika priya.
Ahara sattvika priya.
Very good. So once more I will chant. Please repeat. Ayusattva bala rogya sukha priti vibardhana.
Ayusattva bala rogya sukha.
Once more. Ayusattva balarogya sukha priti vivardhana.
Ayusattva balarogya sukha priti vivardhana.
Yasya snigdha sthira hridya.
Yasya snigdha sthira hridya.
Ahara sattvika priya.
Ahara sattvika priya.
So when if you are splitting, then after hridyaha visarga will come. If you are split and chant, yasya snigdha sthira hridya, visarga will come if you are splitting. If you are not splitting, yasya snigdha sthira hridya ahara sattvika priya. We should know both ways. If you are splitting, it will become Yasya snigdha sthira hridya. Ahara sattvika priya. If you are not splitting, Yasya snigdha sthira hridya. Ahara sattvika priya. So we should teach our children both ways so that they are comfortable and confident. Now, next also is like that, a long word, long samastapada in the first. Kattu amla lavana tyushna tikshna ruksha vidahina. Very nice compound, long, beautiful compound. See, we'll see first the words. Kattu amla. Kattu plus amla become kattu amla. So one word, kattu. Second is amla. Next is lavana. Next is aptushna, very hot. Tikshna, Tikshna means which is burning. Ruksha, that which is very pungent. Didahinaha, if you eat, then it starts to, you know, burn inside our body. So all this such food is known as Rajasa. So what are the words? Kattu Amla. Together become Kattu Amla. See, Kattu Amla. Kattu Amla. So Amla, that little, that becomes beautiful. Kattu Amla Lavana Tyukshna Tikshna Ruksha Vidahinaha. It's also one word. Not, you should not actually split in between. Generally, generally we chant that Kattvam Lalavanatyushna Ikshna Ruksha Vidahinaha. That actually a compound word should not be split like that. So both these two lines should be together chanted. Kattvam Lalavanatyushna Ikshna Ruksha Vidahinaha. Once more, please see. Kattvam Lalavanatyushna Tushna Tikshna Ruksha Vidahinaha. Each word, each letter should be clear. Kattvam, please repeat. Kattvam Lalavana Tushna Tikshna Ruksha Vidahinaha.
Kattvam Lalavana Tushna Tikshna Ruksha Vidahinaha.
Kattvam Lalavana Tushna Tikshna Ruksha Vidahinaha. Ahara Raja Sasyeshta.
Ahara Raja Sasyeshta.
Here actually Padasa, Ahara Raja Sasya Ishtaha. Ishtaha is very dear. Dukkha Shokamaya Prada. That's one word. Dukkha Shokamaya Prada, one word. So how many words are there in this sloka? Kattvam Lalavanatyushna Tikshna Ruksha Vidahinaha, one word. Aharaha, second word. Rajasasya, third word. Ishtaha, fourth word. Dukkha Shokamaya Pradaha, fifth word. Only five words are there, but the words are so tough. Kattvam Lalavanatyushna Tikshna Ruksha Vidahinaha. Please repeat. Kattvam Lalavanatyushna
Tikshna Ruksha Vidahinaha.
Ahara Rajasasyeshtaha.
Ahara Rajasasyeshtaha.
Dukkha Shokamaya Pradaha.
Dukkha Shokamaya Pradaha.
That please be a little careful. Dukkha Shokamaya nahi. Dukkha Shoka Amaya Pradaha. Okay. So when we chant also Dukkha Shokamaya, see that Vibhrada. Okay. Dukkha Shokamaya Pradaha. Dukkha Shokamaya Pradaha. Wrong. Dukkha Shoka Amaya Pradaha. Okay. Amaya means different kinds of sickness of the body. So Dukkha Shoka and Amayam. So Dukkha Shokamaya Pradaha, that's the correct. Dukkha Shokamaya Pradaha, although written like that, but actual pronunciation should be Dukkha Shokamaya Pradaha. Okay. Ahara. Now, if we first we'll chant splitting two words, two lines, and then together. After. Ahara Rajasasyeshtaha. Dukkha Shokamaya Pradaha. Dukkha Shokamaya
Pradaha.
Amayam should be in our mind. Then it will come correctly. Dukkha Shokamaya Pradaha.
Dukkha Shokamaya Pradaha.
So now if you are chanting together, Ahara Rajasasyeshta Dukkha Shokamaya Pradaha. Ahara
Rajasasyeshta Dukkha Shokamaya Pradaha.
So if you are chanting together, then that visarga will be dropped. If you are splitting, and then that visarga will be there. Okay. Once more, let us chant. I will chant. Please repeat once.
Tattvam lalavana tishna tikshna ruksha vidahinaha. Ahara raja sasyeshtaha. Dukha shokamaya pradaha. Ahara raja sasyeshtaha. Dukha shokamaya pradaha. Okay, one more verse we'll see and then we will do a revision. So they are talking about food. First, Bhagavan is speaking about sattvic food. Then now he is spoken about rajasic. Now it is tamasic food. What kind of food is tamasic? Is the 10th verse. Yeah. So first we'll see the words, then we'll chant the verse. Yatayamam, first word.
Yatayamam.
Gatarasam.
Gatarasam.
Uti.
Uti.
Paryushitam.
Paryushitam.
Cha.
Cha.
Yate.
Yate.
Uchishtam.
Uchishtam.
Api.
Api.
Cha.
Cha.
Amedhyam.
Amedhyam.
Bhojanam.
Bhojanam.
Tamasapriyam.
Tamasapriyam.
Here, Uchishtam api chamedhyam. There are only sandhis are there. Uchishtam api become Uchishtam api. Chamedhyam is cha amedhyam. Okay? Medha buddhi. Amedhyam, that which will not help for our buddhi. That's the meaning of amedhyam. Yatayamam gatarasam.
Yatayamam gatarasam.
Uti paryushitam chayate.
Uti paryushitam chayate.
Uchishtam api chamedhyam.
Uchishtam api chamedhyam.
Bhojanam tamasapriyam.
Bhojanam tamasapriyam.
Comparatively, this verse is easy. Yatayamam gatarasam. Uti paryushitam chayate.
Yatayamam gatarasam. Uti paryushitam chayate.
Uchishtam api chamedhyam. Bhojanam tamasapriyam.
Uchishtam api chamedhyam. Bhojanam tamasapriyam.
Yatayamam gatarasam. Uti paryushitam chayate. Uchishtam api chamedhyam bhojanam tamasapriyam.
Uchishtam api chamedhyam bhojanam tamasapriyam.
That's good. We have finished four verses. If you have any doubt, please raise your hand. Then you can ask and then we will clarify that. Anyone?
No, Kavita.
She said. Oh, what is it? You know, please, switch on her audio, na? CC for me, then I can hear. Audio is not there. Okay, right. Please, right. Okay, right. What is it? Sloka number 9.
The law, is it hard or soft?
Sloka number 9. La. Kattvam la.
Tvam, see what happens in south. In south we chant that's la, okay, the soft one, la. But in north they don't have that la, really they don't use it. So I think we should allow both. Like in when we are teaching our children, tvam la lava, amalam is what we use in south, okay. But in north they say amla, la only, they don't have la. So when we teach to our children, we can teach us katvamla, lavana. This amla, one is like la. So we can use what's happening? So when we chant, so we can chant like katvamla and lavanatushna. But North Indian children, maybe it'll be a little difficult for them to chant la. So we'll allow them to chant katvamla lavanatushna. Okay. But in South we chant that as a la, not as la. So katvamla lavanatushna. So first one becomes la, second becomes la. Is it clear? Kavitaji, is it clear? Anyone else? Any other doubt? Ah, yes. Who is that? Ah, please. Can you connect with the audio?
Hari Om Swamiji.
Hari Om.
This is with respect to Shloka 8, Sukha Priti Vardhanaha.
Yes.
Over there, the doubt is between Kha and Pra. So, can it be pronounced as Sukha Priti or Sukha Priti?
Sukha Priti Vivardhana. Sukha Ayusattva Bala Yogya Sukha Priti Vivardhana. Sukha Priti Vivardhana. In that way, the verse becomes more clear.
So, there is a slight stress on the pa, right?
Sukha Priti. Actually, we are giving more stress to the ka because of the ka pre pa may because ra is coming after prana, so that pra becomes little stress comes there. But actually, the because ka is adhikara, so ayusattva bala rogya sukha priti vivardhana. Okay, sukha priti vivardhana. That will be better.
Okay. Thank you.
Then, okay, please. Yeah, please. Which one?
Shloka number 8.
8, yes.
Yes. It is sthira ridhyaha. Or it is combined.
No, see if you are chanting it like verse, line by line. So dasya snigdha sthira hridya. After sthira also there is a visarga. That visarga will change into h. So it become dasya snigdha sthira hridya. If you are splitting, ahara sattvika priya. If you are not splitting, it become Dasya snigdha sthira hridya ahara rajasa priya sattvika priya. What I want to say is if you are not splitting, dasya snigdha sthira hridya, because after sthira also there is a visarga, that visarga will change into h because ha is the next one. Okay, if you are not then hridya, if you are splitting, if you are not splitting, It will continue. Dasya snigdha sthira hridyaha. Aha
Vidya Satvika Priyaha. Otherwise, Yasya Sdigdha Sthira Hridya Ahara Rajas Satvika Priyaha. That's how it is.
Okay, Swamiji.
Okay. Hari Om, sir. Can we go for the next four verses? Okay. Any doubt? Anyone else? Any doubt? Perfect. So we go to 11th verse, isn't it? 11th verse. Here also, first verse is, first we'll see the padas. Abhala kaṅkṣibhihi. Abhala kaṅkṣibhihi. Yatnyaha. If you have a pencil, please mark a little bit so that we know what is the words. Abhala kaṅkṣibhihi. Yatnyaha. Vididrishtaha. Yaha. Ijyate. Yashtavyam. Eva iti manaha samadhaya saha sattvikaha. That is how we split the verses. Okay. Abhalakangshipihi yajnaha vidhidrishtaha yaha ijyade yashtavyam eva iti manaha samadhaya saha sattvika. This is how the words are split. Now we will see the verse, shloka. Abhala kaṅkṣibhir yajñaha.
Abhala kaṅkṣibhir yajñaha.
Vidhidrishto ya ijyate.
Vidhidrishto ya ijyate.
Yashtavyameveti manaha. Yashtavyameveti manaha.
Yashtavyameveti manaha.
Samadhaya sa sattvikaha.
Samadhaya sa sattvikaha.
Abhala kaṅkṣibhir yajñaha.
Abhala kaṅkṣibhir yajñaha.
Vidhidrishto ya ijyate.
Vidhidrishto ya ijyate.
Yashtavyameveti
manaha.
Samadhaya sa sattvikaha.
Samadhaya sa sattvikaha.
So this is how we split, we chant them, splitting each line. First line, second line, third line, fourth line. Now let us chant joining first and second lines together. That what happens is that yajnaha will become yajno because of sandhi. Abhala kaṅkṣibhir yajno vidhidrishto ya ijyate.
Abhala kaṅkṣibhir yajno vidhidrishto ya ijyate.
Abhala kaṅkṣibhir yajno vidhidrishto ya ijyate.
Abhala kaṅkṣibhir yajno.
Yashtavyameveti manaha. So that's how we stand when we split. But when we split and chant together, that visarga will change into sa. Okay? So it becomes yashtavyameveti manas samadhaya sa sattvikaha. Yashtavyameveti manas samadhaya sa sattvikaha. Manas samadhaya. Manah samadhaya ni. Manas samadhaya. Yashtavyameveti manas samadhaya sa sattvikaha. Abhala kaṅkṣibhir yajñaha.
Abhala kaṅkṣibhir yajñaha.
Vidhidrishto ya ijyate.
Vidhidrishto ya ijyate.
Yashtavyameveti manaha.
Yashtavyameveti manaha.
Yashtavyam eva iti.
together becomes yashtavyameveti manah. Samadhaya sasatvikah. So this is the verse. Here we have to, there one place sometimes the children make a little bit of this is abhala kangshi bhir yajno, that bhir yajno, sometimes when children chant you become abhala kangshi bhi yajno, that bhir, that rebha, sometimes they make a mistake. That's a place we have to little careful about. Abhala kangshi bhir yajno, that children chant abhala kangshi bhi yajno, that is one place they make mistake. Another is yashtavyam eveti manaha. There is yashtavyam eva iti. Sometimes yashtavyam eva, that little bit, it's kind of not very clear there. These two places we should pay a little bit more attention. So once more I will chant, please repeat. Abhala kangshi bhir yajnaha.
Abhala kangshi bhir yajnaha.
Vidhi drishto ya ijyate. Yashtavyameveti manaha.
Yashtavyameveti manaha.
Samadhaya sasatvikah.
Samadhaya sasatvikah.
Together. Abhala kankshibhir yajno vididrishto ya ijyate. Yashtavyameveti manas samadhaya sasatvikah. So here, please mark that yajnaha also samadha. So two places we have to be a little careful. Now 12th verse. We'll see the padas. It's a very easy one, not much complicated. Abhisandhaya tu bhalam. Dambhartham api. There's only one sandhi there. Dambhartham api becomes dambhartham api. Chaiva is chaiva yate. Ijyate bharata shreshta tam yajnam vidhi rajasam. That is the paracheda. Very easy one. Abhisandhayatu phalam.
Abhisandhayatu phalam.
Dambha, dambhārthamapi chaivayate.
Dambhārthamapi chaivayate.
Abhisandhāyatu bhalam.
Abhisandhāyatu bhalam.
Dambhārthamapi chaivayate.
Dambhārthamapi chaivayate.
Ijyate bharata shreṣṭha.
Ijyate bharata shreṣṭha.
Ijyate bharata shreshtha.
Ijyate bharata shreshtha.
Tam yajnam vidhi rajasam.
Tam yajnam vidhi rajasam.
Tam yajnam vidhi rajasam.
Tam yajnam vidhi rajasam.
Abhisandhayatu phalam dambhartham api chaivayate.
Abhisandhayatu dambhartamapichaivayat.
Abhisandhayatu phalam dambhartamapichaivayat.
Abhisandhayatu phalam dambhartamapichaivayat.
Ijyate bharata shreshtha tam yajnam vidhi rajasam.
Ijyate bharata shreshtha tam yajnam
vidhi rajasam. Ijyate bharata shreshtha tam yajnam vidhi rajasam.
Ijyate bharata shreshtha tam yajnam vidhi rajasam.
Now I want to tell something. We should not expect this from children, but only for our understanding. You see, there is tam yajnam, no? See, This is only for our understanding. Eh? Tam plus yajnam. Is there, no? So there is in Sanskrit, there is a rule. Anuswarasya yai parasaranaha. This visarga is there. If visarga is followed by this letter, then there is a possibility, it is not must, that this visarga will change into the anunasika, the nasal sound. So it becomes taiyajnyam. So we should not expect children to, you know, learn, understand this, but for our understanding, so that tam yajnyam is perfectly okay. But there is an optional prayoga as the tam anuswara change into anunasika. Anunasika nasal. So it becomes tayajnyam, tayajnyam vidhi rajasam. That nasal sound comes there. But this is an optional rule and we should not expect children to understand this. But when we are learning, I think we should know this options also. Clear, no? What I'm trying to so when if that that comes, then it becomes tanyajnam, and that nasal ya comes there, tanyajnam. But let us not teach that to children because some teachers may not appreciate it. This is an optional rule, but for us we should know, okay, that such a rule also exists. Okay, ijyate bharata shreshtha.
Ijyate bharata shreshtha.
Tam yajnam vidhi rajasam.
Yajnam vidhi rajasam.
So if the nasal sound comes, it becomes tanyajnam, tanyajnam, yeah? Tanyajnam vidhi rajasam.
Tanyajnam vidhi rajasam.
But we'll teach children, tam yajnam vidhi rajasam. Okay, that's very important. Once more we'll chant together. Today I will chant this repeat once more.
Abhisandhayatu phalam dambhartham api chaivayate.
Abhisandhayatu phalam dambhartham api chaivayate.
Ijyate bharata shreshtha tam yajnam vidhi rajasam.
Ijyate bharata shreshtha tam yajnam vidhi rajasam.
We go to the next verse. Vidihinam, the verses, words. Vidihinam, asrishtanam, mantrahinam, adakshina. Four words in the first two lines. Vidihinam, asrishtanam, mantrahinam, adakshina. Next. Saddhavidahitam, yajnam. Tamasam parichakshate. Shraddhavirahitam yajnam tamasam parichakshate. It's a very easy one, not much complicated, very easy one.
Vidhihinam asrishtanam.
Vidhihinam asrishtanam.
Vidhihinam asrishtanam.
Vidhihinam asrishtanam.
Asrishtanam. Asrishtanam means without cooking food for general public. So whenever there's a yajna happens, we should feed people. So asrishtam, srishtam to create, asrishtam not to create. Okay, so asrishtanam means where there is no public, feeding is not given. So whenever yajna is there, we should give food to people. So asrishtanam. So see, when we have this meaning in our mind, no, and then chanting also become little more deeper and understand.
Vidihinam asrishtanam.
Vidihinam asrishtanam.
Mantrahinam adakshinam.
Mantrahinam adakshinam.
Mantrahinam adakshinam.
Mantrahinam
adakshinam. Mantrahinam adakshinam. So we should not chant mantrahinam adakshinam. Mantrahinam adakshinam. Mantrahina adakshinam. Okay. Mantrahina adakshinam. Vidhihinam asrishtanam.
Vidhihinam asrishtanam.
Mantrahina adakshinam.
Mantrahina adakshinam.
Mantrahina adakshinam.
Mandrahinam adakshinam. Mandrahinam adakshinam. Shraddha virahitam yajnam.
Shraddha virahitam yajnam.
Shraddha virahitam yajnam.
Shraddha virahitam yajnam.
Tamasam parichakshate.
Tamasam parichakshate.
Vidhihinam asrishtanam. Mandrahinam adakshinam.
Vidhihinam asrishtanam.
Here one place is that nam, no? Vidhi nama srishtanam nahi asrishtanam and nam, that na, that should be there. Vidhi nama srishtanam mandrahi nama dakshinam. Vidhi nama srishtanam mandrahi nama dakshinam. Shraddha virahitam yajnam.
Shraddha virahitam yajnam.
Tamasam parichakshate.
Tamasam parichakshate.
Vidhihinam asrishtanam. Mandrahinam adakshinam.
Vidhihinam asrishtanam. Mandrahinam adakshinam.
Shraddha virahitam yajnam. Tamasam parichakshate.
Shraddha virahitam yajnam. Tamasam parichakshate.
It's a very easy one. Next one. Now about tapas, very beautiful verses. So we'll see the words first. Deva dvija guru pratnya pujana. This one word. Deva dvija guru pratnya pujana. Five words together, one compound word. Deva dvija guru pratnya pujana. Shaucham, second word. Arjavam, third word. Brahmachayam, fourth word. Ahimsa cha shariram tapaha uchyate. Tapaha uchyate, because of sandhi become tapa uchyate. That means is dropped. Deva, so this here, no, little, we have to little be careful with the children. They should not split the, you know, wrongly. Deva dvija guru prajna pujanam. So when we teach children also, first we should ask them to tell each word. Deva dvija guru prajna pujanam. So when we, once the children are familiar with the words, then it's easy for them. Otherwise, they become Deva Dvija Guru. That will become very little. Deva Dvija Guru Prajna Pujanam.
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 Shaucham Arjavam. Here also, Shaucham Arjavam ni Shaucham Arjavam Arjavam Virga. Shaucham plus Arjavam. Straightforwardness. Shaucham Arjavam.
Shaucham
Arjavam. Deva Dvija Guru Prajna Pujanam. Shaucham Arjavam.
Deva Dvija Guru Prajna Pujanam. Pujanam shaucham arjavam.
Deva dvija guru prajna pujanam shaucham arjavam.
Deva dvija guru prajna pujanam shaucham arjavam.
Brahmacharya mahimsa cha.
Brahmacharya mahimsa cha.
Shariram tapa uchyate.
Shariram tapa uchyate.
Shariram tapa uchyate.
Shariram tapa uchyate.
Here one problem is there. That is that prajna shabda. You know, this prajna shabda, this jnya is very differently chanted in different places. The jnya, this letter, no? In many places in North India, they say gya. So jnani, they write, and then they pronounce it jnani. You know, this is a very very common pronunciation, especially north. So jnya, they say gya. So now here also prajna pujanam. Sometimes, you know, they say pragya pujanam. That should be a little careful when we are teaching. Now, which is correct? See, this jnya is actually ja plus nya. No, generally they say gya. Gya is jnya is pronounced as gya. Gya is actually another word, g plus ya. So it's two. So we should be a little careful about this jnya. Jnya is actually ja plus nya. So jnya, prajna. We have to be a little careful with that. Children, when they chant, because generally, you know, everywhere they see these letters are gya, jnani. They don't say jnan, vijnan. They write vijnan, but they say vijnan. So this should be a little, we should pay a little extra attention to this word. Deva, dvija, guru, prajna, pujanam. So if they ask, no, but we have learned like this. So please tell them this. This jnya is a compound word. Jnya is a compound word. But what are the words here? Okay, the words, the letters are j plus jnya. Please teach them this. Okay, when they say gya, gya is actually g plus ya. In Hindi, it may be perfectly okay, but in Sanskrit, we should should teach them to this is to be pronounced in this way. That will be a nice tip for the children also. Okay. So deva dvija guru prajna pujanam saucha marjavam.
Deva dvija guru praja. Pujanam shaucha marjavam
brahmacharya mahimsa cha shariram tapa uchyate
brahmacharya mahimsa cha shariram tapa uchyate.
Okay, so now if we have any doubts in these four verses, we started from 11th, 11, 12, 13, 14, any doubts, please you can clarify now. Yes. Kavita? Okay.
Fourteenth sloka.
Which one is this? What is the doubt?
She's like, can you please tell us the different options for
Brahma?
Brahma.
Oh. Brahmacharya. Ah, that is a very nice. Very good question. No? See, her plus ma. Oh, sorry. Okay, this is a very good question, Kavita. Thank you for asking this. How, you see, this letter, no? So how to split this letter? H plus ma. But when we pronounce the opposite way. We say Brahma, ma plus ha. This is how we pronounce. But we write as H plus ma, and then we pronounce it ma plus ha. So, and then we say that our Sanskrit is so, you know, perfect. See, this is a rule. The rule is, after H, if any anunasika swara, letter comes. Anunasika means the nasal, like the nasal of ka is nga, kavarga is nga, chavarga is nya, tavarga is na, tavarga is na, like all those, okay? Na, then ma. If all this comes, there is a rule that anunasika letter should be pronounced first. This is a rule. So what is the rule? After her, any nasal anunasika akshara comes, that anunasika akshara should be pronounced first. This is a rule in the Ucharana Shastra of Sanskritam. That's why When we write H plus Ma, actually it is Hma, but in pronunciation it becomes Brahma, Mha. Ma should come first. Now, this is a very another example is what is this? Fire, no? Vahini. Vahini. Actually, it's written Vahini. But how we pronounce? We pronounce Vanhi. Na comes first. Vanhi, that's why we pronounce. Why? Because of this rule. Because Na is an anunasika, as a nasal letter. So, because nasal letter is coming after H, that nasal letter should be pronounced first. And Nshabda. So this is a very prominent usage in our. So Brahmacharyam, Brahmacharyam is not advised. Brahmacharyam is advised because that means there Hma, H plus Ma, that Ma should be pronounced. Now in Veda, little bit difference is there. In Veda, Yajurveda follows this way. Rigveda follows the other way. In Rigveda, many places Brahma, Brahmana, Brahmana, Patim, like that. But in certain Vedic, little bit changes are there in usage, in the Laukika Sanskrita. So in Veda, in this Sanskrit is also of two kinds. Vaidic Sanskrit, Laukika Sanskrit. In Laukika Sanskrit, this is the rule. After Hakara, if any nasal Akshara comes, that nasal should come first. But when you sometimes when you listen to Vedic chanting, you will hear change. That is because of the Vedic rules. Okay, so here it will be Brahmacharya, not Brahmacharyam, Brahmacharya. Ma comes first. Sometimes people will ask us also why we are chanting. You are writing Brahma, and then why you are chanting Brahma? Because of this rule. Clear? Is it clear, Kavitaji? Thank you very much for asking that question, because people are, sometimes. Anything else? Done? Oh, okay. Sir.
Yeah. Hari Om, Swamiji.
Hari Om.
Yeah. In the verse number 12,
yes.
Normally the children have the tendency to chant the Abhisandhayatu Phalam. Earlier. So the correct pronunciation, it seems like Tu Phalam.
Abhisandhayatu phalam.
The children have a tendency to chant the fa, fa, fa.
Ah, yeah. That is another problem with that letter. This letter is very. So, actually, it is. What do you say? Where is it? One okay. This letter is known as Atikhara. So first letter ka cha ta ta pa, there are khara. Next letters are known as Atikhara. So this is pa. Okay, what is how khara becomes Atikhara? By the stress. So pa, pa, not fa. Many, in Kerala, in many places, this letter very wrongly pronounced as fa. Fa, that is, this will not become fa. Pa, when you add her into it, it becomes pa, pa. Pa, pa, ba, ba, ma. Phalam, not phalam. Phalam is a wrong pronunciation. So in North India, they pronounce it very correctly. No, phal. Not that they don't, but phal. No? So, but that the children has this because many places they don't teach this letter very properly. So many people, they say, phalam, phalam. But it will not become phalam because to make khara to adhikara, her is added. So it becomes pa, pa, ba, bha, ma. So we have to correct the children. This is a place where we can actually correct the pronunciation of this letter. Thank you. Okay, Ram Chant, okay. Anything else? No? Anybody else? Any question?
Hari Om Swami, with respect to the previous question which the person asked last time, when you pronounce it as pa, but in yesterday's class you mentioned that when pa comes after visarga, there is a kind of an F kind of a sound which comes up. So is it still that F kind or a PH kind of sound?
There, that is now when visarga is coming. Just a minute. Now that is another pronunciation difference. That is what I said yesterday was, if visarga comes in front of pa, okay, then that visarga is changing into fa. There it's okay. Like ka, 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 krishna, f. That f comes, correct? Fpa, fpa. But that fpa is not bha. This is two letters. This is here, pragardha visarga sadrisya. Fpa. Like the snakes, that fpa. Here, there's another letter, very different letter, known as pa, pa. Pa, pa. There, we are actually giving stress to pa. Pa, pa, ba, ba, ma. Now, yesterday what we studied was, in front of pa, if visarga comes, that visarga will change into upadmaniya. What is upadmaniya? Upadmaniya is pragardha visarga sadrisha. Now, that visarga change into half. So it becomes pa. No? Na, ka, kaha, pikaha. Becomes ka, kaf, ka, kaf, pikaha. Actually, two things. One is we are talking about a letter, pa, pa. Yesterday we studied was when visarga, how the visarga is pronounced. Visarga is pronounced as half. So it becomes pa. I hope you understood.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. So let us go to the next set of verses. We have to finish a little bit because otherwise we don't get time. Okay? Anybody else? Please, Umaji.
The 12th verse. The abhisandhaya or samdhaya?
That is both are okay. Abhisandhaya is also right. Abhisandhaya is also right. Abhisandhaya is better. That anuswara, abhisam, no? Sam change into na.
Okay.
So there is a, I'm just telling this because somebody else asked you, then, so there is a rule in Sanskrit that if this anuswara is followed by any word, that anuswara changes to ne. So that's why it becomes abhisandhaya. So abhisandhaya, some say, but abhisandhaya is a better version.
Okay.
Abhisandhaya is not wrong, but abhisandhaya. Hmm. Better version.
Okay. Thank you, Swamiji.
We'll go to the 15th verse. We'll see the words. Anudvegakaram.
Anudvegakaram.
Vakyam.
Vakyam.
Satyam.
Satyam.
Priyahitam.
Priyahitam.
Cha.
Yet.
Swadhyayabhyasanam.
Swadhyayabhyasanam.
Eva. Vangmayam. Tapaha. Ucchyate. This is a comparatively safer verse.
Anudvegakaram Vakyam.
Anudvegakaram Vakyam.
Satyam Priyahitam Chayat.
Satyam Priyahitam Chayat.
Anudvegakaram Vakyam.
Anudvegakaram Vakyam.
Satyam Priyahitam Chayat. Swadhyayabhyasanam chaiva. Swadhyayabhyasanam chaiva.
Swadhyayabhyasanam chaiva.
Vangmayam tapa uchyate.
Vangmayam tapa uchyate.
Vangmayam tapa uchyate. Chyate.
Vangmayam tapa uchyate.
Here two things we have to be a little careful. One is that swadhyayabhyasanam. Sometimes the children chant swadhyayabhyasanam chaiva. Swadhyayabhyasanam. That's wrong. Swadhyayabhyasanam. Swadhyayam plus abhyasanam. So becomes swadhyayabhyasanam chaiva vangmayam tapa uchyate. Here we should pay attention to the important thing. In our South Indian languages, we have A and A, isn't it? A is also there, A is also there. Eli is also there, Eni is also there. But in Sanskrit, there is no hraswa ekara. In Sanskrit, there is no hraswa ekara. Only A is there. So here also, uchyate is wrong. Uchyate, because A is always dirgha. A, O, like Hindi. Hindi also same. Okay? A, O, they are all dirgha only. There is no hraswa A. There is no dirgha O. What I mean? Sorry. There is no hraswa A and there is no hraswa O. You should be very careful. Sometimes, you know, South Indian children, they chant, vangmayam tapa uchyate. That's wrong. Sometimes they chant the hraswa as dirga, dirga as hraswa. So it should be vangmayam tapa uchyate. Should be two matras. What do you mean by dirga? Two matras dirga. One matra hraswa. E, hraswa, e, two matra dirgha. U, hraswa, u, like that. A, there's no A. In Hindi, in Sanskrit, there's no A. Hraswa is not there. This is something they should teach our children when we are chanting this. Anudvegakaram vakyam satyam priyahitam chayate.
Anudvegakaram vakyam satyam.
Swadhyayabhyasanam chaiva vangmayam tapa uchyate.
Swadhyayabhyasanam chaiva vangmayam tapa uchyate.
Next verse. Manaf prasadaha. See, here that f is coming. Manaf prasadaha. Saumyatvam maunam. Atma vinigraha. If you have a pencil with you, there. Maunam atma vinigraha. Not maunam atma vinigraha. Maunam atma vinigraha. Bhava samsuddhihi. Next word is bhava samsuddhihi. Next is iti. Third is etat. Tapaha. See, in that word, there are lots of words. Bhavasam Suddhi Tetat. How many words are there? Bhavasam Suddhi Iti Etat. Next is Tapaha Manasam Uchyate. So many words are there in this. Okay. Now let us stand. Manaf Prasada. Please listen to this chanting. Manaf Prasada Saumyatvam.
Manaf prasada saumyatvam.
Saumyatvam.
Manaf prasada saumyatvam.
Manaf prasada saumyatvam.
Manaf
Maunamatma vinigraha.
Maunamatma vinigraha.
Maunamatma vinigraha.
Maunamatma vinigraha.
Bhavasam shuddhirityetat.
Bhavasam shuddhirityetat.
Bhavasam shuddhirityetat.
Bhavasam shuddhirityetat.
Tapo mana samuchyate. Tapo mana samuchyate.
Tapo mana samuchyate.
Bhavasam shuddhirityetat. Tapo mana samuchyate.
Bhavasam shuddhirityetat. Tapo mana samuchyate.
Manaf prasad, manaf prasad, please note that, huh? Manaf prasadas saumyatvam maunamatma vinigraha.
Manaf prasadas saumyatvam maunamatma vinigraha.
Bhavasam shuddhirityetat tapo manasamuchyate.
Bhavasam shuddhirityetat.
Bhavasam shuddhiritye tat tapo manasamuchyate. Now we'll chant once more by verse, I mean line by line. Manaf prasadas saumyatvam maunam, sorry. Manaf prasadas saumyatvam. Maunamatma vinigraha.
Maunamatma vinigraha.
Bhavasam shuddhirityetat.
Bhavasam shuddhirityetat.
Bhavasam shuddhirityetat.
Bhavasam shuddhirityetat.
Tapo manasamuchyate.
Tapo mana samuchyate.
Tapo mana samuchyate.
Tapo mana samuchyate.
Next one. Shraddhaya.
Shraddhaya.
Paraya.
Paraya.
Taptam.
Taptam.
Tapaha.
Tapaha.
Tat.
Tat.
Trividham.
Trividham.
Naraihi. Tapastat trividham narai. Nice. But that is verses, words are tapaha tat trividham narehi. Next is abhalakankshibhi yuktaihi sattvikam parichakshate. Abhalakankshibhi
yuktaihi
sattvikam parichakshate. Shraddhaya paraya taptam.
Shraddhaya paraya taptam.
Tapastat trividham naraihi.
Tapastat trividham naraihi.
Abhalakankshibhir yuktaihi.
Abhalakankshibhir yuktaihi.
Abhalakankshibhir yuktaihi. Sattvikam parichakshate.
Sattvikam parichakshate.
Sattvikam parichakshate.
Sattvikam parichakshate.
This is something which is there to be. You know that sattvikam. There is actually two takaras. Generally, children say sattvikam. It's not sattvikam. It is sattvikam. The plus the. The. Okay, sattvikam parichakshate.
Sattvikam parichakshate.
Shraddhaya paraya taptam tapastat trividham narai.
Shraddhaya paraya taptam tapastat
idham narai. Shraddhaya paraya taptam tapastat trividham narai.
Shraddhaya
tapastatvividham aphalakankshibhir yuktai sattvikam parichakshate When we chant together, abhala akankshi bhir yuktai sattvikam, that visarga will change into sa. If you are splitting, abhala akankshi bhir yuktai sattvikam parichakshate, if you are chanting together, abhala akankshi bhir yuktai sattvikam parichakshate. Last verse of today. Satkaramana pujartham.
Satkaramana pujartham.
Tapaha.
Tapaha.
Dambhena.
Dambhena.
Cha.
Cha.
Eva.
Eva.
Yata.
Yata.
Kriyate.
Kriyate.
Tata.
Tad
iha
proktam
rajasam chalam adhruvam satkaramana pujartham apodambhena chaivayat Satkaramana pujartham
Satkaramana pujartham
Tapodambhena chaivayat
Tapodambhena chaivayat
Kriyate tadiha proktam
Kriyate tadiha proktam
Rajasam chalamadhruvam
Rajasam chalamadhruvam
Rajasam chalamadhruvam
Rajasam chalamadhruvam
Kriyate tadiha proktam Rajasam chalamadhruvam
Kriyate tadiha
proktam Rajasam chalamadhruvam Satkaramana pujartham tapodambhena chaivayat Kriyate tadiha proktam rajasam chalamadhruvam
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 We have finished 18 verses. We'll continue tomorrow. Same time. You have any questions in this verses, four verses? Any doubts in these four verses? We can clarify now. No questions. Time up. Okay. So please see tomorrow we can. If anything, we can ask tomorrow. Okay. Thank you. Hario. Tomorrow, 11 o'clock, we'll meet again. Hario. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om